Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to create motion blur effect to your Valorant clip by using Davinci Resolve for absolutely free without any additional plugins and etc. So let's get started. So this is my normal clip, okay? I will just play it. So just normal clip of me getting 3 rare kills in a row. Yeah, so this is like a normal recording, and next I will play you the motion blur clip. So here you can see, right, a bit of blurriness whenever there is a fast movement on the screen. Yeah, so this is what I will be showing you how to do. Okay, so yeah, so let's get started. So just open DaVinci Resolve and create an untitled project, and after that go to settings, and in the settings you will be having this timeline frame rate. Okay, you need to change that to 60. So just scroll down, you'll be having 60. Select that and just click on save, and changing project, yeah, just click on change. And after that, you need to just drag and drop the clip that you want to edit. So I will just drag it and drop it. Yeah. And just click on, would you like to don't change. Yeah. I'll just close this now. So after the drag and dropping, you need to just drag it again and put it in the editing area. And after that, you'll be getting your clip over here. And after this, you need to go to Fusion, like the third option over here. This is edit and this is Fusion. Just click on Fusion. So you'll be having your clip over here. In this, you need to press shift and space keys together, shift and space, and here you will be search for optical flow. Just click on add. Yeah, so it will get automatically added. So if it is not getting automatically added, you need to press the shift key, press shift key and move this. So I will just detach this. So if it gets added like you this way, you need to just press shift key, like drag this, and you need to like place it in between. Like you will be getting these highlighted colors. Press shift and move it through the mouse and place it. So it needs to get connected. Yeah, like shift and drop it like this. So yeah, so here you can see that it is getting connected now. Wherever I move, the lines are also moving. So you need to connect this way. And after this, again press shift and space keys together. This time we will be going for vector motion blur. Select it and just click on add. So again, the exact same thing, shift, and you need to like drop it. So you will be getting this motion blur. So you can like scale, change the scale here, like vector Y. If you scale it, you'll be getting more blurriness. So you can just play around with that in that settings. You need to go to this render queue, deliver, go to deliver, and here you need to like name the file. I will go with motion blur valo, something like that. And I will go with format as MP4. That's a default format. 60, that is fine, and everything is fine over here too. I will just click on add to render queue, and here we need to specify the path. I will go with downloads itself, motion blur valo. I'll just click on save, and here you will be having your job one. You need to just click on render all. So it will take a lot of time depending upon your processor, RAM and stuff, so you need to be just patient. So mine is like a 10 second clip, I guess. Yeah, and it's taking like 2 minutes to render. So depending upon your clip duration, it will take more number of time, so just wait. So once it is done, you'll be getting completed and the duration that it took to complete. So I'll just go to my folder downloads, and here I'll be having motion blur valo. So this is the thing that I've done right now. It's a 7 second clip and it took me 2 minutes 30 seconds to complete. So you can just, you know, predict how much duration is going to take for you based upon that. So I'll just play it now. So here you can see, right, this is that motion blur thing that I'm getting. Yeah, so if you want, you can like scale it up more to have a better effect of motion blur. And I'm just having the plain color. I didn't add any color gradient too. So if you add some color gradient, it will make much more sense. And if you are using skin, it is fine. It will be like automatically cool if you have more colors. So this is it. If you can go to Fusion and you can like change the scale. Yeah, the more you change the scale, the more motion blur effect you are going to get. So that's it for this video. And mine is a programming channel, by the way. I've done tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. You can check the playlist of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.